If you've ever sauntered up to the bar and ordered your whiskey neat, you probably looked super cool doing that. But sadly, and we're not here to judge you here at SciShow, but you ordered a subpar drink. Because it turns out a little water can make your whiskey more flavorful. It's all thanks to the weird chemistry of alcohol solutions. Whether it's an aged Glenfiddich or your standard Jack Daniels, whiskeys can all be boiled down to three basic components. Alcohols, especially ethanol, to get you tipsy, water to keep you from dying, and some yummy carbon-containing compounds to add flavor. In scotches, for example, one of the key flavor compounds is guaiacol, which essentially looks like a ring of carbon atoms with a couple of oxygens attached. It's largely responsible for that distinctive smoky flavor. But what's most important here about guaiacol is that it's amphipathic. Part of it interacts with water, another part repels water. And that means it behaves differently depending on the concentration of water it's dissolved in. To figure out what this all means for your glass of whiskey, a team of researchers carried out a set of computer simulations that modeled various combinations of water, ethanol, and guaiacol. And they already knew that water and ethanol never fully mix. And the shape of alcohol molecules mean that they tend to collect at the liquid surface, a state that minimizes the mixture's overall energy. But while guaiacol can form relatively strong hydrogen bonds with both water and ethanol, the computer data suggested that its carbon ring forms an additional interaction with the alcohol. And that meant that at moderate alcohol concentrations, it followed the ethanol up towards the drink's surface, putting it in a prime position to hit your tongue when you take a sip. The scientists found this concentration effect happened up to about 45% alcohol by volume, which in whiskey terms would be 90 proof. And that might explain why whiskeys and scotches, which are distilled at 130 to 150 proof, are usually diluted down during the bottling process. They literally taste better that way, like you can taste them better. And that wasn't all the researchers found. As the simulated whiskey continued to be diluted past the 45% mark, the guaiacol in it became less and less bound to ethanol. So not only was it at the surface, it lost some of its connections to the liquid around it. That's key because the surface of a liquid is also where evaporation happens. And the flavor you experience when you drink something isn't just what you taste with your tongue. A lot of it depends on the compounds you smell. While the time period studied was too short to actually see evaporation happen, the authors said diluting from 45% to just 27% alcohol would likely increase the amount of guaiacol that became part of the whiskey's smell, and therefore a bigger part of its flavor. And all that means that if you want the most flavorful whiskey experience, you probably want to add in some water instead of drinking it neat. You might even consider watering down other boozes. Lots of flavor-causing substances are amphipathic molecules, so the authors speculated that the tasty components of other drinks could behave a lot like guaiacol. Of course, taste is a complicated personal thing, and some ways of adding water, like dropping in an ice cube, might have other unexpected effects. So, really, like, do your thing. Also drink responsibly. But this is what science says. And before I go, I want to lift a glass to our wonderful community of patrons who support SciShow on Patreon. Our patrons help ensure that our team here can keep making fun, educational science videos like this one. So if you liked what you just watched and you want to help SciShow keep making videos like it, you can head on over to patreon.com/scishow to learn about joining our Patreon community. And FYI, we now have a Discord for our patrons too, so you can check out exclusive channels and talk about SciShow and science with other patrons and some of our SciShow team. We hope to see you there.